Welcome back to this procedural skin video series about how to create your own procedural and skin material into Mari. So this video is about how to set up your scene and how to set up your Mari viewport in order to start doing your first texturing and start, and then you will be able to replicate this texturing into a proper material. So I just wanted to show you how I'm setting up my scene basically. So in order to do that, I will use this model and I will simply import it into Mari. So something that is also really important about this tutorial is that basically I will work on all of my texture into SSCGI. And you want to make sure that you understand the SSCG pipeline, that you understand why we are using SS and why we are not using like a linear color management into Mari. And the reason behind that is that basically when we work into SSCG, we'll get better gamuts and we'll also get better gamma. So better gamut mean that we'll have better values to play with. We'll have like more range. We'll be able to like manipulate a bit more of the range of our colors and the range of our spec map more easily into Mari. So what I encourage you to do, guys, is to have a look at this webinar that was done by Greg Brown. And basically, Greg Brown is explaining a bit more in depth how the SSCG is working comparing to the linear pipeline, to the linear color management. So again, really encourage you to dig inside of the SSCG so you will be able to understand a bit more how we are working into on colors, on texturing with a better color management into VFX studios, VFX companies. So let's see how I'm setting up my Mari scene, how I'm setting up everything. Like the lighting is quite important. So the first thing we'll be working on when we'll dig on the skin texture is the surfacing. So when we are doing surfacing, we need to make sure that we have a proper light scenario in order to show how the surface of our object, how the displacement, the micro displacement, the Mari displacement, or the bump, call it whatever you want, but how the texturing XYZ displacement will work on the surface. So let's just start by selecting our object. So I will just select the high definition of this object. I will export it. So let's say that I want to export that quickly on the test. I will export that as body geo001 and click on export. So what you want to do is also to make sure that when you will export your OBJ, you will have an OBJ with the surface display that will be smooth. So the normals of your surface will be smooth. In order to do that, you can simply select your object. If you are in Maya, then you will go in mesh display. You can do a soften edge and export the result out of it. So just make sure that when you are exporting your OBJ file, export selection as OBJ, you have the smoothing and normals that are on. So let's dive now into Mari. So how we are setting up the Mari scene in order to do that. So we just create a new project, go in file, new, and create my new project. I will load my geometry. Open up this guy. In channels, so because I like to create all of my channels myself and I don't want to use a template that is already suggested by Foundry. So what I like to do is just to make sure that I'm unchecking everything. Then what I want to do is to go in the color setting, and in the color setting, again, we want to make sure that we are working in SS. By working in SS, you should get all of your map that will switch on to SSCGI when you will need it, when you will start creating your maps. Then in lighting, what I want to do is to keep the standard settings, and then I can hit create new project. So now that I have my scene that is open and ready to start, so what I want to do is first to get rid of this diffuse. So I will be using the node graph for this demonstration, for the full length of this tutorial, because basically the node graph, you need to be able to use a node graph, which is something that will allow you to be more procedural and that will definitely allow you to have a way better manipulation over your map. So just really encourage you to use the node graph and not use the layer legacy workflow. So we'll be dealing with the node graph. What we want to do first is to get rid of the former channel that we had before. So I don't even need to use this channel window. Don't need it anymore. I will just need to use the node graph and to have the node property stack that will be available here, and also the light, because I will start creating some kind of custom light. First thing to do is to have a material so we can have a proper display in the viewport. We'll go in my node graph, click on tab, and start writing Arnold. So we'll use the Arnold surface, Arnold standard surface material, Arnold surface shader. So material and the shader are different now in the latest version of Mari. So I will use an Arnold surface, standard surface shader to properly show my object. So we just select this guy, plug it into the default of my viewer. Then I will double click on the Arnold surface standard. So what we want to do here is to customize a little bit more of the shader. So we have something that is representing our standard dielectric material. So what we want to do is to have the weight of the diffuse at 1. Then we want to select a color that will be about between 0.5 and 0.7, so about 70% white, just to make sure that we get something that is like a little bit brightish in the viewport. And then I will click on OK. Then what I want to do is to play a bit more with the roughness. So basically the roughness of my dielectric material should be, so the default roughness should be at about 0.5. Okay, so we leave the surface displacement to guide the roughness on the main specular of our object. We can reduce a bit of the IOR to get something that will be close to skin, something like that. Then I will go into the clear coat and apply a small amount of clear coat. So clear coat in this case will be basically our secondary spec. So I can put a value of 0.3, for example, to start with. Then the roughness will be about 0.2, or can be a little bit higher, let's say 0.25, something like that. And again, I want to reduce the hour to be closest to skin. And we now have the shader that is ready for our viewport. So in order to customize a bit more this material, sorry, this shader or this viewport, actually, we do not want to customize the shader itself now. We want to customize the viewport. So what I will do is to dive into the lights and start disabling all the lights one by one. I will keep the light one, and I will position them the way I want. So how to manipulate the lights? So in order to manipulate the lights, I will select the first one, fix it to the camera and not the scene anymore. And this way I can position it to just be like my key light into the scene. So I want it to be frontal, but not entirely, to be slightly positioned on one of the glancing angle of my model to get something like this. The intensity will stay at 1. So what I want to do with, if I have the intensity as 1, is probably to make sure that I get enough light happening into the scene. So we just take the diffuse of my shader, put that back to 1. Just making sure that the things are consistent. So if we have a light with an intensity of 1, then what we want to do when we are looking at our object and the object has a diffuse at 1, we want to make sure that they are matching, the two of them are matching. So this one is matching to the one I can see in my viewport. So I do not want to expose too much of the value, make them too bright like this, so that's why I'm keeping the intensity with a default value like this. So what I want to do next is to start working on a second light. So I can use a light 2, for example, just make sure that you are working with them one by one. I will select the light number 2, attach it to the camera again, so I can position it the way I want. So I want it to be more like a rim light, so it will happen only on the lateral aspect of my creature. Something like that could work. Okay. Then I can reduce a bit of the diffuse because I don't want it to be too bright. It's here just to rim the side of my object. So I will reduce the intensity. And what I can do as well, it's something that I will do just after, but I will be able to play a bit with the spec and diffuse colors. Not too much. We just want to keep things subtle, but we can color them just a bit. So I will add a third light. I can use the number 3, do the same manipulation, attach that to the camera, use it to rim the other side of my object. So superior lateral side of my creature, like this. Then reduce the intensity to 0.5. And then I can activate the three lights all together. And something that will be working now is that basically when I will turn around my model, look around my model in the viewport, I will have the lights that will follow. Okay, let's go back into the lights. So what we want to do now is to customize them just a bit more. So we can use, for example, the light number 2 and start adding a bit of color. So what I like to do is to use a bit of a bluish light like this, with just a bit of saturation, can be something like 5, for example. Then I will replicate this spec color into the diffuse color. Okay, so we want to pick raw pixels and not screen pixels. Should be about the same result, yeah. Just want to push the value back to 100. Okay. So what we want to do on the light number 3 is to use the opposite color. So I can use the specular light and tint slightly with some kind of orange color, something like this. Saturation of 5. Let's apply it to the diffuse as well. Pick this color. Okay, and then maybe let's say that I want to get more saturation, so saturation of 10. Okay, let's go back to the light number 2, select that and put a saturation of 10 again. To make sure that I have the proper display in my viewport. So this is how I'm setting up my lights, how I'm setting up my basic surface shader in my viewports. And in the next video, we'll see how to start working on the surface displacement and connect that to the bump slot of our shader.